In this tutorial, we're going to be talking about SOD. We're going to start by looking at what SOD is, rational and irrational numbers. We're going to be looking at the rules of SOD, simplifying SOD, conjugate SOD, and finally, we are going to end by talking about how to rationalize SODs. I have a bonus part for us at the end of this tutorial. It's going to be about the differences between quadratic SOD and an ordinary SOD. So, stick around. If there's any question that arises throughout the lecture, feel free to post your comments below and I'm going to get back to you as soon as possible. For us to fully understand what SOD is, we have to first start by looking at rational and irrational numbers. To explain rational and irrational numbers, let's say for example, if you have the number 2, if you have 3, if you have 4.5, 6.7. All these numbers can be expressed as fraction. 2 can be equal to 1, 2 over 1. 3 can be expressed as 3 over 1. 4.5 can be expressed as 45 over 10. And 6.7 can be expressed as 67 over 10. But take for example, if you have a number such as 2 divided by 7. If you press this in a calculator, you are going to get a long array of decimals. It's going to be equal to 0.285714 and so on. If we try to change this to fraction, we can't get a perfect fraction such as this. The same thing with the number pi. Pi equal to 3.14 and a lot of decimals follows it at length. So numbers like this are the first ones, irrational numbers. And these are the first ones, rational numbers. If we extend it to square root, if you look at the square root of 4, the answer is 2. The square root of 16, the answer is 4. But if you look at the square root of 2, you are going to get an answer which has a lot of decimals, 1.41423, and so on. Numbers like this are the first ones, SODs. For example, the square root of 3, the square root of 11. These are the first ones, SODs. They are simply irrational numbers, which are roots of rational numbers. So these numbers are called SOD. So now let's look at the rules of SOD. In mathematics, we know that if you have square root of 4, multiplied by square root of 9, square root of 4 is going to be equal to 2, and square root of 9 is going to be equal to 3, and we have the answer here to be 6. Also, if you have square root of 4 times 9, we know that 4 times 9 is 36, and the square root of 36 is 6. So this part is equal to this part. So we can simply say that the square root of 4 times 9 is equal to the square root of 4 times the square root of 9. So this implies that if you have square root of A times B, this is also equal to square root of A times square root of B. And this gives us the first rule. Now looking at the second rule, you also know that if you have square root of 144 divided by square root of 9, square root of 144 is going to be equal to 12, and square root of 9 is 3, and 12 divided by 3 is 4. Also, if you have square root of 144 divided by 9, 144 divided by 9 is 16. So we have the square root of 16. And the square root of 16 is 4. So this implies that square root of 144 over 9 equals to the square root of 144 over the square root of 9. So here we can say that the square root of a over b equals to the square root of a over the square root of b. And this gives us the second law. The second rule of sort. The third rule we are going to be considering is coming from indices, and we are going to name it also in sorts. If you have 4 to the power of 2, you know this is equal to 4 multiplied by 4, and this is 16. Also, if you have the square root of 4 to the power of 2, you know this means the square root of 4 times the square root of 4. And we know that the square root of 4 is 2 times the square root of 4 is 2, and we have 4. Also, we know if you have square root of 4 from indices, this equals to 4 is 1 for 2. So if you have square root of 4 square, this equals 4 is 1 for 2 over 2, and this equals to 4 1 over 2 times 2 over 1. This we cancel this, and we have 4. So here we can see that if you have the square root of a square, this is equal to a. Basically, what happens here is that if you have the square root of a square, the square is going to cancel the square root of, leaving us with a. So this makes us come to the third rule of sort. When we add the first rule, we got that if you have the square root of a times b, this equals the square root of a times square root of b. This exists only if the operation we have here is multiplication. This does not apply to addition. So therefore, you can't say square root of a plus b equals to the square root of a plus square root of b. This is wrong. And you can say that the square root of a minus b equals to the square root of a minus the square root of b. This can only happen whenever we have multiplication as the operation. We're going to be looking at some other rules of sort as the class proceed. Now, how do we simplify sorts? We have looked at the meaning of sort, and we have seen examples of sort. We have also looked at the rules of sort. If you are to find the square root of a rational number which contains a factor which is a square of number, then we can reduce the sort into a simpler form. Okay, enough of talking. Let's look at some examples. If you have the number root 10, and if you have to use calculator to find this, root of 10 gives us 3.16227766. This depends on the accuracy of the calculator. But if you have to look for the square root of a number such as 16, we are going to have 4. I said earlier, these numbers are referred to as sorts, and this is not a sort. So, for numbers like this, how do we simplify them? So, in the following examples, we are going to be showing how we simplify sort into their basic form and more simpler form. Here we have an example. Simplify square root of 48. If you try to place this in the calculator, you are going to get What we do here is to look for two factors of 48, that the product is 48 and the root of one of them is not a third. We are going to look for two factors of 48, that the product will give us 48 and the square root of one of them is not a third. Let's write out the factors of 48 till we reach the condition we are going to. So we have 1 and 48, we have 2 and 24, here we have 3 and 16. The product of 3 and 16 is 48. And if you check for the way, the square root of 48 is a third. Square root of 48 is a third. Square root of 24 is a third. But the square root of 16 is not a third. So this is where we are going to. So we can simply say that the square root of 48 is equal to the square root of 3 times 16. You get this? I'm going to rewrite this. So we have three sets of factors of 48 here, 1 and 28, 2 and 24, 3 and 16. If you look at these numbers, this set and this set, you see that the square root of all of these numbers is a third. Here we have the square root of 3 is a third, but the square root of 16 is going to give us 4. So the square root of 16 is not a third. So this is the condition we are looking for. So we can express the square root of 48 as the square root of 3 times 16. And don't forget, 3 times 16 equals to 48. So, as we mentioned from the first rule of thought, that if you have A times B, this equals to the square root of A times the square root of B. So here we can have that the square root of 3 times 16 is equal to the square root of 3 times the square root of 16. So we can easily simplify this by saying this equals to the square root of 3 times the square root of 16 is 4. So multiplying 4 and root 3, we're going to have 4 root 3. And this is our answer. So here we can say that 4 root 3 is a simplified form of the square root of 48. And 4 root 3 is the answer. Let's look at another example. Here we have simplified the square root of 54. If you look at the factors of 54, that is going to give us this condition. If you try to write out all the factors of 54, we are going to reach the points 6 and 9. Here we have the product of 6 times 9 to be equal to 54. And we see that the square root of 9 is not a third. So this is the condition we are looking for. So we can express the square root of 54 as the square root of 6 times 9. And as we did in the first example, the square root of 6 times 9 equals to the square root of 6 times the square root of 9. The square root of 6 is a third. And we have the square root of 9 to be 3. So here we can have that 3 times the square root of 6 is going to be 3 root 6. And we have 3 root 6 as a simplified form of square root of 54. So here we have another example. Now it's time for us to look at another rule of third. In mathematics, if you have x plus x, this is going to give us 2x. So also, if you have square root of 2 plus square root of 2, this is going to give us 2 square root of 2. So this is applicable in mathematics too, that if you have the square root of x plus the square root of x, this is going to give us 2 square root of x. So similarly, if you have square root of 3 plus 2 root 3 plus 4 root 3, this is going to give us, this has the coefficient of 1 plus 2, this is 3, 3 plus 4 is 7, and this is 7 root 3. Take note, this is only applicable if you have the same square root. You have root 3a, root 3a, and root 3a. If you have 2 root 3 plus 4 root 5 plus 6 root 3, this is going to give us, since we have root 3a and root 3a, therefore we can add these two numbers. So here we have 8 root 3 plus 4 root 5. And this is going to be our answer to this. So let's go back to our example. Here we have square root of 20 plus square root of 45. If we simplify 20, we are going to have square root of 4 times 5 plus 45 is going to be for square root of 3 times 16. Okay, so here we have 48. This is 48. So we have the square root of 2 times square root of 5 plus the square root of 3 times square root of 16. The square root of 4 is 2 times root 5 plus the square root of 16 is 4. So here we have 2 root 5 plus 4 root 3. So we can see the answer to square root of 20 plus square root of 48 equals to 2 root 5 plus 4 root 3. So we are going to leave the answer as 2 root 5 plus 4 root 3. Also, if you have an example such as this, root 20 plus root 5. From the last example, we know that square root of 20 equals to square root of 4 times 5. And here the square root of 45, we can further simplify it to square root of 5 times 9. So here we have the square root of 20 plus the square root of 45 to be square root of 4 times 5 plus square root of 9 times 5. Here we have the square root of 4 times square root of 5 plus a square root of 9 times square root of 5. The square root of 4 is 2 times square root of 5 plus square root of 9 is 3 times square root of 4, 5. So here we have 2 root 5 plus 3 root 5. And here, since we have the same square root here as root 5 and root 5, so therefore we can add these numbers to be 2 plus 3. So now it gives us 5 root 5. Looking at this example, we have the square root of 20 minus the square root of 45 plus the square root of 125. We have the square root of 20 to be 4 times 5 minus the square root of 45, 9 times 5 plus the square root of 125 is 25 times 5. Here we have the square root of 4 times the square root of 5 minus the square root of 9 times the square root of 5 plus the square root of 25 times the square root of 5. And here we have 2 root 5 minus 3 root 5 plus 5 root 5. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. Minus 1 plus 5 is 4. This is possible because we have minus root 5, root 5, and root 5. So this gives us 4 root 5. Let's look at another example. So here we have the square root of 45 minus the square root of 32 plus the square root of 50 plus the square root of 20. The square root of 45, we can say equals to 9 times 5 minus the square root of 32. And you have 16 and 2 plus the square root of 50. And we have 25 and 2 plus the square root of 20. Here we have 4 times 5. Simplifying this, we have 3 root 5 minus 4 root 2 plus 5 root 2 plus 2 root 5. So if you collect like times, here you have root 5, we also have root 5 here. Here you have root 2 and root 2. So we can say this equals to 3 root 5 plus 2 root 5 minus 4 root 2 plus 5 root 2. So here we have 3 plus 2 is 5 root 5. Minus 4 plus 5 is 1 minus root 2. Oh, this is plus root 2. Before we continue, I want you to try this. We have covered a lot concerning how to simplify sorts, so I want you to try this. Feel free to post your answers in the comments, and we are going to get back to you as soon as possible. So far, we have covered how to change a sort from the normal form to a simpler form. But how do we change a sort from the simpler form back to the normal form? We are going to be looking at these two examples. The first one says we should change 5 root 5 back to the normal form. We are just going to reverse all our steps here. We know that 5 root 5 is coming from 5 multiplied by root 5. And we know before we can get this 5, we must have squared a particular number. And which number are we going to square it for to get 5? That is the square root of 25. So here we have the square root of 25 times the square root of 5. So here we have the square root of 25 times 5. Square root of 25 times 5 is equals to 125. So we have returned this sort from 5 root 5 back to the normal form, which is the square root of 125. The B part of the question, we have 2 root 5 plus 4 root 3. We know that 2 root 5 is coming from 2 times root 5 plus 4 times 3. For us to get 2, we must have squared a particular number. And for us to get 4, we must have squared a particular number. So which number are we going to square for us to get 2? That is going to be square root of 4 times the square root of 5. And this is going to be the square root of 16 times the square root of 3. So this gives us square root of 4 times 5 plus the square root of 16 times 3. And this is going to give us the square root of 20 plus the square root of 16 times 3 is 48. So the answer to this is square root of 20 plus the square root of 48. And this is basically how we return a sort from the basic form back to the normal form. So let's move to the second part of this tutorial. We are going to be talking about conjugate sorts. We said that two sorts are conjugates if their product gives rise to a rational number. First, to best illustrate the meaning of conjugate sort, let's start by recalling and going back to difference of two squares. In mathematics, we have that a square minus b square equals to a plus b, a minus b. And we know that whatever this is going to give us is going to be a rational number. So similarly, if you have root a square minus root b square. Here we are going to have root a plus root b, and then root a minus root b. This is coming from difference of two squares. So let's come back here. Here we have square root of a square minus square root of b square. Recall that in the third rule of sort, if you have square root of a square, you are going to have the answer to be a. And conversely, if you have square root of b square, you are going to have the answer to be b. So here we can say this equals to a minus b, and this is going to give us a rational number. So because the product of this sort and this sort gives rise to this sort, which is a rational number, therefore we say this sort and this sort and this sort, they are conjugates of each other. So if you have square root of a plus b and square root of a minus square root of b, so we say these sorts are conjugates. So let's take, for example, if you have a sort root 3 minus root 2, the conjugate is going to be root 3 plus root 2. Take note, is the sign that changes here. We have negative here and we have positive here. So these two sorts, they are conjugates. Another example, if you have root 2 plus 1, the conjugate is going to be root 2 minus 1. It's as simple as that. Here we have our first example. Simplify 3 root 2 minus 1 multiplied by 3 root 2 plus 1. If you look at this closely, we can see that these two sorts, they are conjugates. We have 3 root 2 minus 1 and 3 root 2 plus 1. Therefore, the product of these two sorts must give us a rational number. If you look at this, we see that it's coming from difference of two squares. We have square root of a square minus square root of b square to be equal to square root of a plus square root of b square root of a minus square root of b. This also is the same with what we have here. So we can say that this sort 3 root 2 minus 1 3 root 2 plus 1 is going to be equal to 3 root 2 square minus 1 square. This is only the case if you have two sorts that are conjugate of each other, just like this. You have 3 root 2 minus and 3 root 2 plus. So we have difference of two squares here. So therefore, we have this serving as our a, 3 root 2 square minus 1 square. So this can be further simplified into 3 times root 2 square minus 1 square. Recall that if you have ab square, this is going to be equal to a square times b square. So here we can say that this equals to 3 square times root 2 square minus 1 square. 3 square is going to give us 9, multiplied by square root of 2 square is going to give us 2. As part of the third rule of sort, whereby we have square root of a square must be equal to a. So here, square root of 2 square equals to 2 minus 1. We have 9 times 2 to be 18 minus 1, and this gives us 17. So here, we have product of these two sorts that gives answer to a rational number, which is 17. Therefore, we say these two sorts, they are conjugates. Here we have another example. This is also coming from conjugate sort. We have these two sorts to be conjugates. 7 root 2 plus root 3 multiplied by 7 root 2 minus root 3. So here we can refer to this sort. 7 root 2 plus root 3 multiplied by 7 root 2 minus root 3 to be equal to 7 root 2 square minus root 3 square. So here we have 7 times root 2 square minus root 3 square. And we have 7 square times root 2 square minus root 3 square. As 7 square gives us 49 times 2 minus 3. And this is going to be 98 minus 3. And the answer is 95. So we have these two solves, in which the product gives rise to a rational number, which is 95. So therefore, we say these two solves, they are conjugates to each other. Here we have an entirely different example compared to the first two examples. We have simplified 2 root 5 plus 3 root 5 squared. Here we are not talking about conjugate solves. If you try to use the method of conjugates, this is not going to work. We can also say this solve 2 root 5 plus 3 root 5 squared is equal to 2 root 5 plus 3 root 5 multiplied by 2 root 5 plus 3 root 5. So what we have here is the entire bracket is squared, so it's not difference of two squares. We have plus here and we still have the same plus here. So going through the method of conjugates will not work. So here you have to apply the traditional method of opening and simplifying brackets in algebra. So to simplify this, we firstly take the first part of this bracket to be 2 root 5 into brackets. We put the content of this bracket 2 root 5. We are putting the content of this bracket plus 3 root 5. Then we take the second number, which is plus 3 root 5. Then we still take the content of this bracket again, 2 root 5 plus 3 root 5. This is simply the traditional ways of opening brackets in algebra. So we multiply 2 root 5 and 2 root 5. So if you are multiplying 2 root 5, multiply by 2 root 5, I'm going to demonstrate it here. We have 2 root 5 times 2 root 5. The whole number is going to multiply the whole number. Here we have, so we have 2 times 2 times root 5 times root 5. Don't forget, 2 root 5 is the same thing as 2 times root 5. So here we have 2 times 2 times root 5 times root 5. So we have 2 times 2 to be 4 times root 5 times root 5 is going to give us square root of 25, and this is going to give us 4 times 5, which is equal to 20. So let's continue with opening this bracket. We have 2 root 5 times 2 root 5. This is going to give us 4 root 25. 2 times 2, 4. 5 times 5, 25. Plus, we see, multiply this by this again. 2 times 2, 3 is 6 root 5 times 5, 25. Plus, here we use this to multiply this. 3 times 2 is 6 root 5 times 5 is 25. Plus, we use this again to multiply this. 3 times 3 is 9 and 5 times 5 is 25. So, far here we have 4 times 12 of 25 is 5. Plus 6 times square root of 25 is 5 again. Plus 6 times square root of 25 is 5. Plus 9 times 5. So far here you have 20 plus 30 plus 30 plus 45. And this gives us 125. What I want us to take note here is the method of opening brackets or simplifying brackets in algebra is still going to be applied in opening this bracket, where the method of conjugates or method of C square is not going to work. We have some practice questions here. Feel free to pause this video, try to solve this, and post your answers in the comment below. This is going to be the last part of our tutorial. We are going to talk about rationalizing the denominator. Before we start looking at examples, let's try to make some analogies here. Consider the sort if you have 3 divided by root 2. Dividing this using calculation might be more cumbersome. So, rationalization is the way of making this simpler. At the end of this section, we are going to talk about the cases in which you need to rationalize. But before we do that, let's look at the ways in which you can rationalize. If you look at this sort, we have 3 divided by root 2. If you multiply this by 1, we have, again, 3 divided by root 2. And don't forget, if you have root a over root a, this equals to 1, just like a over a equals to 1. So, if you come back here and multiply 3 over root 2 by root 2 over root 2, this thing must be equal to 3 over root 2. Don't forget, root 2 over root 2 must be equal to 1. So, multiplying this, if you now decide to multiply 3 and root 2, I will multiply root 2 and root 2, that's simply how we rationalize sorts. Here we can say 3 times root 2 over root 2 times root 2. And here we have 3 root 2 over root 2 times root 2 is going to be 2. And by this, we have rationalized this sort. This sort 3 over root 2 has been rationalized to get this. So that's simply how we rationalize. What we do here is we divide, or I mean, we multiply the sort by the conjugate of the denominator. Here we multiply this sort by root 2 and root 2. And root 2 is the conjugate of root 2. We have another similar example here. We have to rationalize 5 divided by root 7. So here we have 5 over root 7. Then we multiply this to the side over this side. So what will go into this box is going to be the conjugate of this particular sort. So what's the conjugate of root 7? That's root 7. So then we multiply this by this and this by this. So we have 5 times root 7 over root 7 times root 7. And this gives us 5 root 7 over 7. And this is the rationalized version of this sort. 5 root 7 over 7. Here we have another example. We have to rationalize 3 plus root 2 all over root 5 plus root 3. So here you have 3 plus root 2 all over root 5 plus root 3. So don't forget, we are going to multiply this by the conjugates of this sort. So the conjugate of root 3 plus the conjugate of root 5 plus root 3 is going to be root 5 minus root 3. Also, add the denominator of root 5 minus root 3. So, this is going to give us 3 plus root 2 multiplied by root 5 minus root 3. Over. And don't forget, these two sorts, they are conjugates. Therefore, we can say they are equal to root 5 square minus root 3 square. Since this, we multiply this and this also we multiply this and this. So let's simplify the numerator. 3 times root 5 is 3 root 5 minus 3 root 3 plus root 10 minus root 6 divided by 5 minus 3. So this gives us since none of these can be added together, so the answer you are going to have here is going to be 3 root 5 minus 3 is 3 plus root 10 minus root 6 divided by 2. So this is the result of rationalizing this sort. So rationalizing of sort goes in a similar way. You simply multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of the denominator, and you're going to arrive at a rationalized sort. So how do you recognize whether a sort has been rationalized or not? If you check all the examples from rationalization, you are going to see at the denominator part we have a whole number, it's not a sort. So you are not going to have a sort at the denominator. After finishing your rationalization, you must always have a whole number such as this at the denominator aspect. Thank you. In summary, in this class, we've covered the rules of sort. We look at the first rule, the second rule, the third rule, and the fourth rule. We also look at how to simplify sorts. You can easily go back and learn more on this. We look at conjugate sorts and how they are being applied and how questions on them have to be tackled. We also look at how to rationalize the denominator in sorts. So, we have come to the end of this class. If you have any question, feel free to post it in the comment section below. I have one exercise for us here. So let's try to attempt it, and the answer is given below. If you like this video, like, share, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Check our catalog, and we have a lot of playlists on different parts of mathematics that is going to be very useful for you in your academics. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and I'm going to see you in the next tutorial. Don't forget, there's a bonus part after this section, so try and check this out. We are going to be learning about the difference between a quadratic sort and an ordinary sort. Try, stick around and check it out.